Good morning all. Today we are going to discuss how a sine wave can be generated and how can we plot the sine wave easily. After that we will discuss what is the relationship between electrical and mechanical degrees and what is the relationship between the frequency and speed of the rotor. So let us start. So first we are going to start with the generation of a sine wave. So the AC generator or a sine wave generator works on the principle of Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction, which states that the EMF induced is proportional to rate of change of flux linkages. EMF induced is proportional to rate of change of flux linkages. Based on how they are changing, there are two types. One is statically induced EMF and second one is dynamically induced EMF. So this name, whether statically or dynamically, this name comes from whether the field is stationary or the field is moving, or we can tell that the conductor is stationary or the conductor is moving. Let us take for example, I am taking a north pole, south pole. Inside I take a conductor. Let us assume this conductor is moving. So as the conductor is moving and cutting the flux, then this is called as the dynamically induced EMF. Whereas if you go for this transformer, the conductor is stationary. This field is changing with respect to time. That means flux is changing and conductor is stationary. So in that case, it is called as statically induced EMF. What are these EMF and other things? We will see in detail when we are discussing about the electrical machines. So I am not going into detail now. Now our concern is how the sine wave can be generated. Now this magnitude of this dynamically induced EMF is given by the flux cutting law. So what is flux cutting law? So let us take for example, I am taking one conductor. A conductor is there. This is my conductor. This conductor is kept in a magnetic field. Let us assume the effective length of the conductor is LE. And this is the direction of the magnetic flux density B, and the conductor is moving with a velocity V in this direction. And let us assume the angle between B and V is given by theta. So this velocity is in meters per second. Then the dynamically induced EMF will be proportional to V cross B. That means velocity taking the cross product with the flux density, because both are the vectors. So or simple way, if I can write this dynamically induced EMF is equal to B into LE is the effective length of the conductor, which is falling on inside the magnetic field, or which is the length of the conductor that is inside this magnetic field, because conductor can be extended beyond that also. Then V is the velocity of the conductor and theta is the angle between the flux density and the velocity of the conductor. We have to take sine of the angle between them. So let us see how this comes and other things. So let us take for example, I am taking a simple generator. I am assuming there is a north pole, there is a south pole. So whenever you keep the field like this, automatically the flux will produce in this way. So let us assume in this there is a rotor. There is a rotor, inside there is a conductor. There is a rotor and inside there is a conductor. So now the conductor, let us assume this conductor is moving in counterclockwise direction. This conductor is moving in counterclockwise direction. Whenever it moves at different locations. So after some time it will come here. After some time it will come here, after some time it will come here. So let us start this location as 1, 2, 3 and 4. We will see the intermediate also. Let us see at what point how it will cut and how to generate this. So remember this, the dynamically induced EMF, and repeating once again. So this is given by B into LE into V into sin theta. Theta is the angle between B and V. So the direction of the B is nothing but the direction of the flux. So this will be my B, and the direction of V, to find it, you have to take the tangent at the point of rotation. So let us assume at this position, the direction of V will be like this. This is my direction of V. So at this point, this will be my direction of V. At this point, this will be my direction of V. Why the conductor is rotating in counterclockwise direction? So at this point, this will be my direction of V. You have to take the tangent at that point in the direction of the rotation of the rotor. So if a conductor is in between somewhere here, so this will be my direction of velocity. So the angle between B and V should be taken while calculating this one. Either you can calculate using this. This is used for finding the magnitude. And if you want, what is the direction of the current induced? That can be found by using the Fleming's right hand rule. Fleming's right hand rule means you hold your right hand in such a way, your thumb indicates the direction of the velocity, and your forefinger or pointing finger indicates the direction of the flux density. Then your middle finger will indicate the direction of the dynamically induced EMF. Because of this dynamically induced EMF, current will pass in that direction. So let us try to apply it at different points, then we will see the magnitude also. Let us take at point number 2. At point number 2, you can see B and V are perpendicular, so we can apply there. We can apply only if they are perpendicular. You can see here, the angle between two fingers is 90 degrees. So only if it is 90 degrees, you can apply the Fleming's right hand rule. Otherwise, you have to go with this formula to find the magnitude. Okay. Now, I am applying the Fleming's right hand rule at point number 2. So you can see, the pointing finger will point from north pole to south pole, and your thumb indicates towards your right to left. Then your middle finger or your center finger will indicate the direction of the current. If you see it, you will observe the current will come towards us. If the current is coming towards us, generally in a conductor, if a current is coming towards us, it is represented by dot. So that means dot indicates the current is coming towards us. That means current is coming outside your book. And if you are taking cross, cross means it is going inside the book or inside your that mobile, whatever you are watching. So let us see the case at point number 4. At point number 4, again apply the Fleming's right hand rule. If you apply the Fleming's right hand rule, again pointing finger points the direction of the magnetic field, and your thumb indicates the direction of rotation. Direction of rotation is from left to right. Then if your middle finger will indicates into your book, or you will get it as cross. You will get it as cross. Let us see at the remaining two positions. At these remaining two positions, if you calculate, at this position you can see the angle between B and V, because this is the direction of B, the angle between B and V is 180 degrees. So sine of 180 degrees will give the magnitude as 0. So magnitude will be 0. Similarly, at this point, if you calculate, the angle between B and V is 0 degrees. So automatically sine 0 will be 0. So here also dynamically induced EMF is 0. Whereas if you take at this point number 2 or point number 4, you can see angle between B and V is, this is the direction of B, this is the direction of V. So angle will be 90 degrees at this point. So we can tell that dynamically induced EMF will be maximum. So let us take at some other location. I am taking at this location. At this location, so I am just representing here, this is my direction of V and this is my direction of B. This is my direction of B. So you have to take the angle, this angle you have to take. In that way you can calculate. And if you take, let us assume at this point. So let us take at this point so that analysis will be easy. So at this point, if you take the conductor, this is my direction of the velocity and this is my direction of B. What is this angle? This angle is less than 90 degrees. So in that case, what will be the magnitude? Magnitude will not be maximum. So I am just summarizing it. When the conductor is at location number 1, the EMF induced will be 0. As it is going, the EMF will go on increasing. And when it reaches the point 2, the EMF induced will be maximum. Again, when it reaches point number 3, EMF becomes 0. And when it reaches the point number 4, the EMF will again be maximum, but in opposite direction. Let us assume this dot represents that EMF is positive and the cross represents the EMF is negative. Dot means current is coming out of your generator. Cross means current is going into your generator. So in that way I am taking. So this I am representing at different locations. So let us assume at different locations that theta I am taking. So remember this theta is in electrical degrees. So at location number 1, EMF is 0. And when we reach location number 2, 3, 4, so let us see how it vary. At location number 2, it reaches the maximum value. And at location number 3, again we got it as 0. At location number 4, you can see it is in opposite direction and maximum. So it reaches the opposite location. Again, when it reaches point number 1, it completes one cycle, it reaches 0. You can see it is repeating like this. This is my direction of my dynamically induced EMF, either ED or I can represent simply by V. So the maximum value that it reaches, I can represent by V maximum. So this I can write of the form V is equal to V maximum sine omega t. V maximum sine omega t. So this theta I can represent in terms of omega t. With respect to omega t it runs. So how it runs? So to represent that, I am just taking one circle. This circle radius I am taking equal to V maximum. So let us assume this is my circle radius. This radius I am taking equal to V maximum. So this is my reference. So with respect to this reference, let us assume it is rotated by some angle theta. It is rotated by some angle theta. How to calculate this value of theta? because we are telling the theta at different location. How to calculate this theta? Because we know that EMF induced will always be equal, be generated at the rate of omega t radians per second, or what is the frequency that I want to generate. So for that, because we know your rotor is rotating at omega radians per second, your motor is rotating at, or the rotor is rotating at angular frequency of omega radians per second, it is rotating at omega radians per second, then the value of theta, the theta can be obtained as theta is equal to omega radians per second, but I want theta is the angle in radians. So how to get radians? You have to multiply radians per second with time. That means what will be this? Radians per second multiplied by time is in seconds. So this will give my value in radians. So theta becomes radians. So how to calculate theta? Theta you can get by multiplying what is the speed of the rotor in radians per second multiplied by time. That gives me what is the location of the theta. Got it? So let us now see how to plot the sine wave in easier way. How to plot the sine wave in easier way. So for plotting the sine wave, you take a circle. You have to take the circle with the radius equal to your maximum value of your EMF. You have to take the radius equal to maximum value of your EMF. So now I am just doing. So what I will do next, now you divide your entire circle into different parts, into equal number of parts. Let us assume this is part number 0, this is part number 1, part number 2, part number 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. Total 12 parts are made. So same way you have to divide your x-axis, because this is nothing but theta. So same theta I am representing here, dividing this axis into 12 parts. So I am representing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. So now what I will do, I will extend a vertical line from every point. I am just extending a vertical line. So every point I am drawing the vertical line. So now how to get the value at a particular point? When it is 0, the magnitude is 0. If you want to get what is the value when theta is equal to at location 1, so whatever is theta you can measure it. We know theta is equal to omega into t, omega multiplied by the time taken to reach here. So you can just draw a horizontal line. You can see this horizontal line is intersecting here. That means it is at this location. So at theta is equal to 2, so you have to extend and intersect with 2 here. So it will reach this location. At theta is equal to 3, so you have to extend this, it will reach here. Similarly, at 4, it will reach here. Similarly, at 5, it will reach here. Similarly, at 6, it will again reach 0. That means if you plot this using a smooth curve, so you will get your graph like this. This is my sinusoidal wave. This is for positive half cycle. Now, similarly for 7. Sorry, I have just made it wrong. So it will be 6, right? It will come here. Please make the correction. So it will be here, right? At 5, this is the location. So now similarly for 7, 8 also, you can just make the extension in the similar way. That means 7 I am extending downwards, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So similar way I will extend from here. So at 7 and 11 it will be at this location. Similarly 8 and 10 will be in the same line. So 8 and 10 it will be at this location. Similarly 9 it will be at this location. So again I can extend this. So I can extend this and draw my sine wave. So it will get a sine wave like this. So how to get a sine wave? You just take a crank wheel or a wheel, divide it into multiple parts. The radius of this wheel should be equal to maximum value of your voltage. So this, you have to take this radius, R is equal to V maximum value. So then you divide this wheel into small parts. So same parts you have to make in the horizontal axis, where this is given by theta is equal to omega t. So in this manner you have to do it. So then automatically you plot it. Do the vertical lines from each point and draw the horizontal lines from the wheel at every point, wherever they are intersecting, that forms your sinusoidal wave. So in this way you can calculate this. So let us now see what is the relationship between electrical and mechanical degrees. So relation between electrical and mechanical degrees. So just now we have seen that when you are taking a north pole, when you are taking a south pole and your conductor is rotating in this direction, we have seen that when the conductor from this point number 1, when it reaches the north pole 1, 2 and south pole, again coming back. That means when it is moving like this, we have seen that when it goes under the north pole, we get maximum, under south pole, we get negative maximum, and when it goes through one north pole and one south pole and coming back, that means whichever point it start, it is crossing through one pole, two poles. That means when a conductor is crossing through a pair of poles, then it is completing one cycle of EMF. That means one pair of poles gives one cycle of EMF. Everyone agree with me? So let us take for example, I have extended the number of poles. I have taken the north pole, then south pole. I have taken another north pole and another south pole. Now a conductor is there, the conductor is rotating from this point. Let us assume point number 1. So we know by the time the conductor reaches the north pole, EMF will be maximum. Then by the time it comes under the south pole, EMF will be negative maximum. And when it reaches here, it becomes 0. Again, when it reaches the north pole, again it becomes positive maximum. And when it reaches under the south pole, again it gives negative maximum. You can see here, this will be my reference point. With respect to this reference point, when you are moving from point number 1, it completes one cycle. First one is under north pole, south pole. Again, when it comes under the next north pole, again it will be positive. Next south pole, it will be negative. That means, here the number of poles is equal to 4. How many cycles are coming? So, cycles is equal to 2. Or otherwise, we can tell that the number of cycles will be equal to P by 2. Pair of poles. Pair of poles. Getting it? So, in electrical degrees, we have seen the cycle of electrical cycle. We have shown that one cycle is equivalent to 2 pi radians or 360 degrees. This is called as electrical angle. Because within same rotation, one rotation itself, we are generating two cycles. We cannot call it as mechanical angle. This we can call as 360 degrees. Getting it? That means this angle, this 2 pi or 360 degrees, whatever we are telling, this is nothing but whatever the cycle we are representing the angle, that is called as electrical angle. So, electrical angle. So, now one complete rotation of your rotor is equal to 360 degrees because this angle is a mechanical angle. So, one mechanical angle, in one mechanical angle, how many electrical angles are completing? P by 2 times of electrical angles are completing. That means P by 2 times of electrical angles in completing in one rotation. Or if you want to calculate at a particular location what is the electrical angle, electrical angle I can calculate by P by 2 times of theta mechanical. Let us try to cross verify. Let us assume in our example, your rotor has completed one cycle. When rotor has completed one cycle, what is the mechanical angle covered? Mechanical angle covered is 360 degrees. And pair of poles, because how many pair of poles are there? Two pairs. So, 2 into 360 degrees. You can see here theta electrical is, by the time it completes one rotation, how much is completed? 360 plus 360. So, 720. So, two cycles are completed. So, I can tell that if you want to calculate theta electrical at any point, if you know the mechanical angle, I can calculate by the formula theta electrical is equal to P by 2 times of theta mechanical. That means theta electrical is always greater than or equal to theta mechanical. That you have to remember automatically, you can get this formula. This is the relation between electrical angle and mechanical angle. I hope this is clear to you. So let us now see how to calculate the frequency. Let us assume the speed of my rotor is n revolutions per minute. I am assuming my rotor is rotating at a speed of n revolutions per minute. In 1 minute, it is rotating n revolutions. Always the speed is represented in RPM. So, everything I am representing in electrical in terms of seconds. So, I can tell that the speed will be equal to n by 60 revolutions per second, RPS. It is revolutions in 1 second. Because per minute, if we can rotate n, per second it will be less. It is 1 by 60th of that. So, n by 60 I have calculated. So, if I want to calculate the frequency, because we know the frequency is equal to the cycles per second. Cycles per second. So, this I can write as number of cycles per revolution into revolutions per second. I can write like this. So, what are the number of cycles per second? Sorry, cycles per revolution. In one revolution, how many cycles are completing? We know in one revolution is nothing but equal to one complete rotation of mechanical degrees. So, I can tell in one revolution how many cycles are completing. We have just go back to this. We have seen that whenever you are taking two poles, one cycle is completing. Whenever four poles are there, two cycles are completing. Or in a generalized way, we have discussed that number of cycles per revolution will be equal to P by 2, because by crossing two pair of poles, it complete one cycle. So, I can tell that P by 2 cycles per revolution multiplied by revolutions per second. Revolutions per second will be equal to N by 60. Or from this, I can write my frequency is equal to N into P by 120. So, this is the relationship between frequency and the speed of the rotor. Remember here, this N is in RPM, revolutions per minute, and P is the number of poles. P is the number of poles. I hope this is clear up to now. So, let us try to solve some 1-2 numericals so that whatever we have discussed in last class and this class, it will be clarified to you completely. So, I am taking the examples. So, I am taking the first example. It is given, what is the time period of the wave produced by a 6-pole alternator which is driven at 1000 rpm. This is the numerical given. So, whenever any numerical is given, first thing for you is to make it easy, first note down what is the given data. So, note down every data either in pictorial form or in data form. It is given there the number of poles is equal to 6 and the speed is given as 1000 rpm. So, now it is asked what is the time period of the wave produced. You have to calculate what is the time period T. So, we know T is equal to 1 by F. So, first I want to calculate the frequency F. How can I calculate frequency F? Frequency F is equal to Pn by 120. So, just substitute this, P is equal to 6, the speed in RPM I have to take, so 1000 divided by 120, this will give my frequency as 50 Hz. So, I can calculate my time period, so time period will be equal to 1 by 50, this will give 0.02 seconds. So, let us take another example, an alternating current of frequency 60 Hz has a maximum value of 120 amperes. Write down the equation for its instantaneous value. Find the time taken to reach ampere for the first time. An alternating current of frequency 60 Hz. So, let us write to the given data. So, given data I told, first you have to note down that it is written a frequency is given as 60 Hz has a maximum value of alternating current is given. So, this becomes maximum value of the current is 120 amperes. Write down the equation for instantaneous value. So, I have to find this. Then, what is the time taken to reach 96 amperes? So, when current is equal to 96 amperes, what is the time taken for the first time? When it is moving for the first time? So we know that equation, sinusoidal current I can write is I is equal to I maximum sin omega t. I maximum sin omega t. So omega is nothing but 2 pi f. We have seen this, what is angular frequency in last class. So this becomes I maximum into sin of 2 pi f into t. Just you have to substitute that. So this becomes I maximum is 120 into sin of 2 pi into 60 into t, or this I can write as 120 into sin of 120 pi into t. This is my value of instantaneous current. I have just substituted it. Now it is asked to find when current is equal to 96, what is the time? So I can write it as 96 is equal to 120 into sin of 120 pi t. So from this I can calculate my time t is equal to 1 by 120 pi into sin inverse of 96 by 120. So this will become equal to 0.00246 seconds. You can calculate with your calculator, or otherwise this I can write as 2.46 milliseconds. Got it? From this I can calculate my time. So let us take another example to further clarify this. I am taking another example. The expression of two voltage waves are given below. So the voltage waves given are VA is equal to 100 sin omega t plus 30 degrees, and another wave is given VB is equal to 75 sin omega t minus 15 degrees. So what is asked is VA leading VB or VB leading VA. This is the first question. And the second question, it is asked, determine the phase angle between VA and VB. Let us see this. So whenever a wave is given, better represent in the form of a plot so that it will be clear. So first wave is given VA is equal to 100 sin omega t plus 30 degrees. So to calculate what is the angle, so you just take whatever is inside that omega t plus 30, equate it to 0. So this will become omega t is equal to minus 30 degrees. So this axis is omega t, that means it crosses the 0 at omega t is equal to 30 degrees. So it crosses 30 degrees. So at this point it is starting, so automatically your wave will be something like this. This is my voltage wave VA, whatever is the wave. So remember here, I think I have not drawn it properly because we have to take it as 30 degrees, right? So I am just redrawing it so that confusion will not be there. So it is starting at 30 degrees. This is my wave VA. So what is this angle? This angle is 30 degrees. Now coming to the second wave, so VB again you equate it to 0. So this becomes omega t minus 15 is equal to 0, or I can tell omega t is equal to 15 degrees. That means the second wave reaches 0 at omega t is equal to 15 degrees. So this will be equal to 15 degrees. At 15 degrees it is reaching 0, or it is starting after 15 degrees. So this is my value of VB. So now out of these two, when you are moving from left to right, which wave is coming first? That will be leading the second wave automatically. So which wave is coming first? We can tell that VA is coming first, and after how many degrees? 30 plus 15. That means after 45 degrees, the phase B is coming. So we can tell that the phase A is leading phase B. That means in the part A, VA is leading VB is correct. Now determine the phase angle difference between VA and VB. So to determine the phase angle between VA and VB, so what we have to do? We have to subtract the angles between them. So subtracting the angle, you can see the first one is coming omega t is equal to minus 30 degrees, and second one is coming as 15 degrees. So here you have to apply something like this. A person has started from this point. There is a point A. There is a point B. So point B is at 5 meters. Calculate the distance between point A and point B. Let us assume point A at 1 meter. How you are doing? What is the point B minus point A, 5 minus 1 we are telling. So same way I can calculate this. To calculate this difference between these two, I can subtract these two. So this becomes 15 minus of minus 30. Because omega t is coming, minus 30 here. I am subtracting these two. So 15 minus of minus becomes 15 plus 30. So this becomes 45 degrees. In this way you can calculate. That means the phase difference between these two is equal to 45 degrees. Got it? I am repeating once again. Whenever you are want to calculate the phase difference between these two, just equate that inside the sinusoidal term to 0, you are getting some value. So similarly for second one also you get the value. Take the difference of these values including the sign. So that means I am subtracting 15 minus. For phase A it is minus 30 degrees. Minus into minus become plus. So it becomes 45 degrees. In this way you have to solve the numericals. So next class we are going to see the average value and try to solve some numericals on the average value, and after that we go for root mean square value and what is its significance. So if you still have any queries related to the topic discussed today, so you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries from there. If you feel that any topic is not clear, you can just leave the comment there. I will try to prepare the video lecture for that particular part and I will upload for you. Thank you. Thank you very much.